हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई स्वाति वर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट स्कूल ऑफ मेडिकल एंड अलाइड साइंसेस, गलगोटियास यूनिवर्सिटी, शेल बी डिस्कसिंग विद यू अबाउट मॉलिकुलर प्लॉटिंग एंड प्रोबिंग टेक्निक्स. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वट आर मॉलिकुलर प्लॉटिंग टेक्निक्स, वट आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ प्लॉटिंग एंड प्रोबिंग टेक्निक्स. Now we will talk about your next technique, that is your northern blotting technique. So the northern blot or RNA blot is a technique which is used in molecular biology research to study gene expression by detection of RNA in a sample. So here what we detect, we perform the detection of RNA or your isolated messenger RNA in a sample. With northern blotting, it is possible to observe cellular control over structures in functions by determining the particular gene expression rate during differentiation and morphogenesis, as well as in abnormal or diseased condition. Northern blotting involves the use of electrophoresis to separate RNA samples by size. We use northern blotting technique to separate RNA samples by size and detection with a hybridization probe that is complementary to part of or the entire target sequence. The term northern blot actually refers specifically to the capillary transfer of RNA from the electrophoresis gel to the blotting membrane. However, the entire process is commonly referred to as northern blotting. The northern blot technique was developed in 1977 by James Elwell. Northern blotting or northern blot hybridization is a particular variant of southern blotting in which the target nucleic acid, that is RNA, instead of DNA. So in case of northern blotting, our target nucleic acid is RNA, not your DNA. This method is used to measure the amount and size of RNAs transcribed from genes and to estimate their abundance. In this technique, an RNA extract is electrophoresed in an agarose gel using a denaturing buffer to ensure that the RNAs do not form inter or intramolecular base pairs. So in this particular technique, what we do, an RNA extract is electrophoresed in a agarose gel by using a denaturing buffer. After electrophoresis, the gel is plotted onto a reactive DBM, that is diazobenzoyl methyl paper, and hybridized with a labeled probe. RNA bands can also be blotted on nitrocellulose paper using appropriate conditions and suitable nylon membrane. Nylon, which is a generic name for a long chain synthetic polymer having recurring polyamide, that is your CONH groups. Two types of nylon membranes are available commercially. First is your unmodified or neutral nylon. Second is charge modified nylon. What type of nylon will bind single and double stranded with nucleic acid? Now if we talk about your eastern blotting technique, the eastern blot or eastern blotting is a biochemical technique which is used to analyze protein, post-translational modifications including the addition of lipids, phosphates and glycoconjugates. So the eastern blotting technique, which is also known as your eastern blot, is a particular biochemical technique which we use to analyze protein post-translational modification. The post-translational, after translation, the modification that will occur in the protein during the translational process, to analyze that particular post-translational modification, we will perform your eastern blotting technique, including the addition of lipids, phosphate and glycoconjugates. It is most often used to detect carbohydrate epitopes. We often use it to detect the carbohydrate epitopes. Thus, eastern blot can be considered an extension of the biochemical technique of western blot. So, we can use eastern blot technique to detect the carbohydrate epitopes. Thus, we can refer your eastern blot technique as an extension of biochemical technique of your western blot. Multiple techniques have been described by the name Eastern blotting. Most use PopSo protein blotted from sodium dodecyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis onto a polyvinylidene fluoride or nitrocellulose membrane. So the membrane that we use in this particular case is your either sodium dodecyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis or by means of your polyvinylidene fluoride or your nitrocellular membrane. These transferred proteins are analyzed for post-translational modifications using probes that may detect lipids, carbohydrate, phosphorylation and other protein modifications. Eastern blotting should be used to refer to methods that detect their target through specific interactions of the post-translational modifications and the probe. So we can refer your Eastern blotting technique to detect their targets to through specific interaction of the post-translational modifications and the probe, distinguishing them from a standard FAST plaque. In principle, Eastern blotting is similar to your lectin blotting. So basically, it is similar to that of your lectin blotting in case of it, if we talk about its principle. Now, for more information, you can mail me on this particular mail ID. Thank you.